Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, and I'm writing a book, or rather revising my previous book, on the first Gnostic principles of one God, one faith. And here is the chapter one, and the whole book is written in spirit. That means no references as the other people do it, you know. They are men of letters, and they ply dead letters, quoting each other. When you have the Spirit of God, then you do not need the references from others, but you are the one who are dominating them, because we are the sons of the Most High Supernatural Father. And these priests, they are men of scriptures. They go by what is written. And there they have limitations. We don't have any limitations. So here I present my third part of introduction. And I would appreciate if you correct my English and any other criticism, you bring it up. It would be much, much appreciated. Now the moral laws are centered around the creator demiurge God called Yahweh. In the Middle East, called Khuda in Arabic and Brahma in Hindi. A jealous and revengeful God, as the once born natural man is in his image, and Abraham was planted by Yahweh to demonstrate the moral laws through practical examples presented by his seed, the chosen people. So they are the demonstration nation of the world. And we should appreciate their sacrifices and learn from their mistakes. So if they are faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, then both the blessings are on you. In the name of Abraham, then you can be independent. You don't have to be a slave, because your father, tribal father, will protect you. And in the Yahweh, he will be the one who brings rain and make your soil fertile, so that you can have good fruit, good food, honey and milk. That is what this promised land used to be when they were faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. I will tell you that they are not faithful today, and they are getting bundled up for final burning. Whenever these chosen people were faithful to Abraham, Yahweh, they received the blessings of Heavenly Father Yahweh through rain and crops, making the land a garden of Eden, so that the faithful chosen people could enjoy the company of Yahweh through food and protection. But as soon as they became unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, which we call the tares, sons of Satan, the same land becomes barren. The same land became barren, and the chosen people were forced out to an exile, as I told you about this. Jacob had 12 sons, 11 were crook, and they were jealous of Joseph, for he was faithful to Jacob and to Abraham. He was not a liar. He will tell these things straight. Again, I will explain this in details in a separate chapter on the chosen people. It's good to devote the whole chapter to these chosen people so that you can appreciate the qualities of these chosen people and how the demiurge god Yahweh fed them when they were faithful. Further, according to the religious qualities, there are four ages, and these are well represented in swastika worldwide. They go in the cycle, and the cycle beginning with all the religious qualities intact, living in the company of Yahweh as the sons of the Most High, Elohim, Par Brahma, Allah, our supernatural Father, and ending in this dark age today called Kal Yug, which stands for the famine. Kal means famine of religious qualities. There are four things, you know, conscience, shame, truth, contentment, and mercy. When all these three qualities disappear, these are religious qualities, then only quantity, shame, which is the tribal father's shame, is left. Then only you can appreciate the message given by the Christ or Satguru. Christ stand for Satguru. Satguru stand for Sat mean gospel truth. Guru mean one who preaches the secrets, which is the logical reasoning of our Father. His word is called Logos. Logos stand for logical reasoning. The extract or the nectar of logical reasoning is called Logos. So Kal, famine of religious qualities, and Yug means age. This is the dark age. That is the why Christ comes, the very Son of our Father comes. Only during this age, God, our supernatural Father, that has domination over the demiurge Yahweh, because he is supernatural. In Yahweh, we have natural Father. Under natural Father, he is jealous and revengeful. Supernatural, he is not jealous and revengeful. He is opposite, loving and merciful. So, demiurge Yahweh and his nature. So, our supernatural Father has domination over Yahweh. That means the Son also has the domination over nature. He stopped the storm. He made the dead people alive. All he did it against nature. Cure the sick, give the eyesight, everything. All these are miracles because he belonged to our supernatural Father. So in this dark age, you remember when Jesus was going to Jerusalem, then he was lamenting that, look, hey Israel, look, how many prophets are sent to you to mend your way? When they come to tell you and you beat him, sometimes you maltreat them. Then fed up with you that our Father God has sent his own Son, that you will recognize him as they did. The temple priest knew he was the Christ, but they did not want to tell the other people in case they lose their grip on the people. As today, you know, these priests in churches, they know doctor priest. They are antichrist. But they keep quiet. Sorry, you know. Hello. I'm busy. Okay.